Please say and spell your first and last name for me.
Sure, it's I go by Danny, but I'm gonna spell Daniel D-A-N-I-E-L. Dudek is D-U-D-E-K.
All right, great. So we hear you're a North Carolina native.
And I'm gonna.
Sorry, sir.
Yes, yes. I was just gonna tell you, I'm also a lieutenant colonel, so that LTC is what we go by.
You're with the Army, correct?
Is that volume okay for you, sir?
Okay.
Yes.
So I guess what have you been doing so far out there while you're in Colorado?
Well, the air's a little thin out here, so we got to acclimate. So we came out here about a week earlier, and so I've been training in the two major sports that I'm doing. One's racing wheelchair, and the other one's swimming.
And how are you enjoying that so far?
Oh, I think you can see behind me. Can you see me on the camera? It's gorgeous out here. And it's been like this for the past week and a half. It's like 45 in the morning, and then it gets up to about 78, 79. In the afternoon, and it's really warm, but it just feels great.
Okay, now it sounds like you're having a great time, so I don't want to kind of kill the spirit of you having a good time, but can you take us back to the moment when you were injured and describe how that has impacted your life since?
Well, sure. I joined the Army after I graduated from Appalachian State University, and that's when I got commissioned an artillery officer. And so since 92, I've been an artillery officer at many different locations. So I was with the 4th Striker Brigade out of Fort Lewis, Washington. I was the brigade fire support officer with that brigade in Iraq, north of Baghdad. That's part of the surge. And so I was just going from one place to another with the brigade commander. And we were just on a combo with 5 strikers going from Taji to Kambani Saad. North of Baghdad, and when an IED came to the back of the striker, killed the kid next to me, and I've become a spinal cord injury, so everything below my knees is paralyzed. And so that was kind of a long recovery. You know, of course, my wife was there for me the whole way, which I knew everything was going to be okay, and it really has. I've had a great support from the VA hospital that I spent 3 months at, Walter Reed, and the community that supported me, and the ability to stay in the military and continue to serve. And so it's an incredible amount of opportunity that's been put in front of me, and an incredible amount out of windows that have been opened so that I can, you know, see all the different capability and the adaptive ways I can do things to enjoy life. It's really been a phenomenal experience, and something that I could have never imagined how incredible my life could have changed after I got wounded.
How do you find not only the physical strength but the emotional strength to participate in the Warrior Games that you're doing right now?
Well, most of my emotional strength really comes from my spouse, Megan. I chased her for 3 years, and usually it's just 1 year tour in Korea, but I extended for 2 additional years chasing her, trying to convince her to marry me, and it was well worth it. So we had been married for 16 years now, and she is my inspiration to try to stay positive and keep improving myself and make sure I'm earning her, the ability to stay her husband, and so that I can do really good things and enjoy life. And it's that's where a lot of my inspiration comes from. And of course, my family, my parents, Bob and Peggy Dudek, that are still there in Wilmington, they give me a lot of inspiration, as well as my family. I have a little sister, Sarah, older sister, Katie, who teaches middle school out there, and my little brother. So, just having that family background and having a spouse that supports you, it's just, you can't ask for better.
My husband, he's in the military, so I already know there's a strong camaraderie between everyone in the military, almost no matter what branch you're in.
What does he do?
He's a Marine stationed at Camp Lejeune right now.
Oh, wonderful. No, we do a lot with the Marines, and it's always nice to, when you're sharing battle space, with people who know their job as well as we do. So it's always good to be out there.
Yeah, so I want to ask you, since there's already a strong level of camaraderie amongst people in the military, are you experiencing that on a new level now that you're meeting other injured veterans?
Yeah, there's a lot of camaraderie with the disabled population, whether you're an amputee or a spinal cord injury like me, or you just have some fragmentation in your arm or you're banged up just a little bit. Everybody wants everybody around them to be successful, and as soldiers, we want to compete. So while you're in competition with me, I'm gonna do my best to beat you. But when we're out at the hospital, we're out training, everybody's sharing as much knowledge as they can, because everybody just wants to encourage each other to be as much as they can to enjoy that quality of life as best as possible. And so even though there's an enormous amount of competition between us and the Marines here, and it's a lot of fun, we do all want each other to be as successful as possible.
Well, you've done a wonderful job answering my questions. And lastly, I guess, anything you want to say to your family that's still here in Wilmington before we go?
Well, my dad's out here with me. I wish I could bring him on camera with me, but to say hi to my sister, Sarah, my sister, Katie, my brother, Andrew, and his wife, Blake, and a new daughter, Opal, and my mom, Peggy Dudek, and Debbie. Just miss you guys terribly, and thanks for rooting for me and all your support.
All right. Well, thank you so much. We'll check in with you, and hopefully we'll be able to find out how you did. Best of luck with everything.
Yeah, she'd do well for swimming. She had to wait till after Saturday.
Okay. All right. Well, have a good time. Enjoy yourself. All right.
Thank you
very
much.
Your service, too, sir. Bye.
All right. Bye-bye.